Good day to all of you. As all of you know, today you will all appear for a practical test of Impress 1. In this practical test, you will be asked many questions and you will need to practically show how you will do these on your computer. Let us now understand the rules for this test. This is a practical test for you in which you need to show one by one how you will use each of the options being given to you. This test is of 45 minutes duration. For all the questions that are given to you, you will be shown a video of the correct way to answer the same so that you can see for yourself if you have answered the questions correctly or not. You can compare your answers with the video. In case you have answered wrongly, then you can learn the correct method of answering by watching the video. Now, all of you switch on your computer and open the Impress file using the method taught to you. Let us now begin the test. First, insert 4 slides. Take the first slide as title slide and type in the given line. Then copy paste it 5 times, making sure that each copied line appears in a new line. Show your responses to your teacher. With the help of this video, let us now see the correct method of doing copy paste. Firstly, since in our slide presentation, we need to insert 5 new slides. So first let's do that. Bring your pointer to the slide pane as is being shown in the video and then right click on it and then click on the new slide option. So you get the second new slide. Then again, we need 5 slides. So once again, click on the slide pane, right click. And then click on the new slide option, you will get another slide and similarly the 4th and the 5th slide. Now, since we want to copy paste our line which is in the first slide, we scroll up on the slide pane and then click on the first slide where our text is. Now, when we go to the area where the text is written and click there, a box will appear around our text. Then we need to first select the line that we need to copy. So we can select this by using the keyboard, the arrow keys or the mouse and the touchpad. Once we have selected it, we can use the shortcut command for copy, which is Ctrl plus C. When you do Ctrl plus C, you will not see any change. But when you do a paste with shortcut Ctrl plus V, you will see it being pasted. So first, since we want the new line, press enter and then do a Ctrl plus V to get the second copy. Similarly, press enter and do Ctrl plus V to get the third copy. Then again, press enter and do Ctrl plus V to get the next copy. And one more time. So this way, when you copy, you just use the shortcut command Ctrl plus C, but that time you don't see any change. But when you paste, when you do Ctrl plus V, you can do it many number of times to make copies. Now select the lines one by one and show how you will make the text of a line bold italic. Also show how you will change the font color. Show your responses to your teacher. Let us watch this video and see how we can apply the various aspects on the fonts like bold, italic and font color. So to do that, we first need to select the first line to apply bold. After selecting the line, take your pointer to the format where B is written and click on B and your text becomes bold. The text that you had selected becomes bold. Now let's select the next line. For selecting, you can use the mouse, touchpad or the keyboard to select. After you have selected, remember that bold can also be done with the shortcut Ctrl plus B. Now second line, we need to do italics. Take it to the I button, click on that. The shortcut for this is Ctrl plus I. So you can see that your second line, which was selected, has become in italics. Let's select the third line because we also want to change the font color on this line. So after selecting, take your pointer to the A button or where A is written in the format bar, and on the side, on the right side of A, there is a drop down button. Click on that and you will see many colors available to you. Select the color that you like and click on that, and you will see that that color gets applied to your selected line or to the selected text. So this is how you can make changes on your font. Next, practice the find and replace option. Using this option, find the word mission and then replace it with vision. Once you have done this, show it to your teacher. With the help of this video, we will now see how to correctly use the find and replace command. So we have to find environment in this text on the slide, the word environment, and wherever it appears, we have to replace it with climate. So to do that, you can do it, find and replace. There is a shortcut command, Ctrl plus F. So you can do a Ctrl plus F. Try that and you will see a box will open. So in this box, now we need to write the word that we are looking for. So since we are searching for environment, we have to type environment in the search for box. So as is being shown in the video, we just type the word environment here, environment, and then we click on the find button. So as soon as we click on the find button, the first time it locates environment, it will get highlighted. Again click on find and the next word environment will get highlighted. So on, you will see all the times that environment appears gets highlighted. Now we want to replace it with the word called climate. So in the replace with place, you have to type climate, C-L-I-M-A-T-E. And then when you click on replace, it will keep replacing one by one. Or if you replace all, click on replace all, in all the places, the word environment will become climate. This box appears which says the document search is finished. So you can click on OK in this to close this box. So it is just saying that all the environment words have been replaced by climate in our text, and then close the find and replace box. So this is how you can correctly use the find and replace command. Now show how you will hide all the options of the toolbar. Once you have done this, show it to your teacher. So let us now see how we can hide the various toolbars. And to do that, we need to first take a pointer to the view menu of the menu bar. Click on that, left click, and then bring your pointer to the toolbars option. You can see the ones which are selected. So click on the drawing toolbar and you will see that the drawing toolbar from the bottom of our slide gets hidden. Once again, click on view and bring your pointer to toolbars. Next is line and filling. Click on that and the line and filling toolbar gets hidden. One more time, take your pointer to view, left click, bring your pointer to toolbars, and then click on the presentation option. So the presentation toolbar also gets hidden. And lastly, we will once again click on view, bring to toolbars our pointer, and click on standard. And you will notice that the standard toolbar also gets hidden. So this way you can hide various toolbars. Next, change the next slide into a content slide and show how you will insert a picture in this slide. However, remember that to insert any picture, you will not use the insert menu. Once you have done this, show it to your teacher. Let us now see how we will insert a picture in a content slide. So since we now want to insert a picture, we select the next slide, the second slide, which is a blank slide. And from the slide layout, we make sure that this is a content slide. So the one which we have selected is the title content slide. So in this slide, you can see that there are four options available. You can insert many things using this. So you can insert a table, or you can insert a chart, or you can insert a picture. So in our case, we want to insert a picture. So we will click on this particular option, left click here, and you will see a box opens showing you various pictures which are available on your computer. So you can select a picture from here, or if you want to look at a different location, you can select the location from the address bar. We have selected lighthouse and clicked on open, and you will see that the picture of the lighthouse gets inserted on your slide. This is how you can insert pictures. Convert the next slide into a blank slide. Use the drawing toolbar to make a drawing in this slide. Once you have done this, show it to your teacher. In the next slide, we need to use the drawing toolbar to draw something in a blank slide. So first, we need to click on the third slide. And then, since this is still a title content slide, we need to take a pointer to the slide layout box. Click on blank slide, it becomes a blank slide. Now, we don't see the toolbar at the bottom of our slide because we had hidden it earlier. So to bring it back, we need to first take a pointer to the view menu of the menu bar, left click on that, and then bring a pointer to toolbars option and click on the drawing toolbar. So you will see that the drawing toolbar is once again available to you. Now, let's select from the stars, one of the options in the drawing toolbar, and we select one of these which we want to use to draw in our slide. So we have selected the signet option, then we click on the slide and drag. And a drawing of a signet appears on our slide. Now, if we want to make changes to it, like for the boundary line, you can either click on the view option and get back the line and filling toolbar, or if you look on the right side of the slide, you can use this also to change the outline of the signet. You can also change the style of the line, and you can change the color if you like of the outline like this. You can see many colors here. Choose the one which you like. Again, there is a fill in option also, so you can, in the drawing, you can fill in. If you click on the down arrow button here, you have various options available, gradient, hatching, bitmap. So select the one which you like we have selected bitmap, and then if you click on this box here, you will see various styles of bitmap available, and let's select one. Let us select the artificial turf, and as soon as we click on that, your drawing gets filled in with that. So this is how you can use the drawing toolbar to draw an image on your slide. Again, make the slide blank and insert an object from the gallery option. And then type some lines about it. And after typing, show it to your teacher. Let us now see how we can make use of the gallery option to insert a picture in our blank slide. So since we need a blank slide, we first select the next slide from our presentation, and then we go and click on the blank slide layout to make it blank. It becomes blank. Now we need to insert a picture from the gallery option. So we take a pointer to the tools menu of the menu bar, left click on that, and then left click on the gallery option. So the gallery option opens up, and you can see many themes are here: arrows, backgrounds, bullets, computers, even environment, diagrams, so on. So let us choose from, let's say, computers. So left click on that picture that you want to insert, and then after you have selected the picture, you need to right click on it, and it has a copy option. When you click on copy, your image gets copied on the slide. Now you need to close the gallery option. You can do so, you can use the shortcut by clicking on the buttons which are shown here just below the gallery. When you click there, the gallery gets hidden. Or by going back to the tools option and clicking on gallery option there. So now we have our picture inserted in the slide. We need to write about this computer. We need to use the text tool. We bring a pointer down here to the text tool, click on that, and then click on the slide and drag. So you will get a box where you can type your text. So let's start typing here. You can type any line that you like about the computer. The one which we are typing is, a computer is an electronic machine. So this is what we are typing. You can see this in the video. You can of course type your own line. And once you have written the text, you can also do formatting on the text. You can increase the font size, change the font color. You have learned so many things. So computer is an electronic machine which makes our work easier. So this is what we have typed here. And then we can click on the side, so the box disappears and our slide is ready with the line that we wanted to write. Next, show how you will insert the slide number. And also show how you will change the background color. Once you have done this, show it to your teacher. With the help of this video, let us now see the correct method to insert the page number or the slide number and also change the background. So for this, take your pointer to the insert menu, click there, and then click on page number. So you will see a box which is the box for header and footer. Select the slide option because we have to insert the slide number. Now we don't need the date and time, so we can click here and unselect it. Also, we don't need the footer, unselect that. Just select the slide number, click on that option, and then we can click on apply to all, so that it gets applied to all the slides. This is the fourth slide, so number 4 has been inserted. Now, we also need to change the background. So bring your pointer to the format menu of the menu bar. Left click on that and then left click on the page option. From the box that opens for page setup, click on the background option because we have to change the background, and then click on the drop down box for fill. So there are many options here, color, bitmap, hatching and so on. So you select the one which you like, for instance color, and then you see many colors are available. You can scroll up and down to select the color of your choice. So we select the turquoise color, click on that, you can see it in the preview also, and then click on OK. A box opens which asks you background settings for all pages. So if you say yes, it applies to all slides. If you say no, it only applies to the slide that you are working on. So we have clicked no, so it gets applied the background color on slide number 4. Next, show how you will apply custom animation on the text and image. Once you have done this, show it to your teacher. Let us now see the correct method to apply custom animation to the text and images in our slide presentation. So, since we want to apply custom animation to all the slides, select the first slide which has the text lines. There are many lines here. So, since we want to apply custom animation to the lines, let's first select the first line. So, select this either using your keyboard, mouse or touchpad. Once you select this, now you can either go to the menu bar and use the options from there, or you can come to the right side of the slide and you see the custom animation icon. Click there and you will be able to use the custom animation option directly from here. So this is a shortcut method of using custom animation. Now you see add has got highlighted. You can click on add, and a number of themes for applying custom animation are available to you. So you can select one which you like. You can also see a preview on the slide because your automatic preview is on, and then click on OK to apply this custom animation. You see in the preview window that the animation has been applied to the selected line. We are selecting the second line now. After selecting, again take the pointer to the add option, left click on that, and from the themes which are available, you can scroll up and down to see all the themes available. Click on the one which you like. You can see it applied on your slide as a preview. And then when you click on OK, the preview window on the right side of the slide shows that this animation has been applied to this line. Now let's select the third line because we want to apply animation to this line also. So as is being shown in the video, select the line. Again take the pointer to the add option on the right side of the slide. Click here, left click. And then let's look at the emphasis options now for custom animation. There are many, so you can just select one. We have selected flicker, or you can select wave for instance, and the text will be coming in waves. Click on OK, and you can see in the preview box that this animation has been applied to the third line also. Selecting the fourth line now. After selecting, we have to take the pointer to the add option in the custom animation area. Left click on that, and from the themes which are available, you can scroll up and down if you like to see more. And when you click on any of these themes, you can see it being applied to the slide because your preview is on. Click on OK. And you can see the fourth line has come. We are now selecting the fifth line. After selection, again take the pointer to the add option, left click on that, and then the themes will open up, the box will open up for custom animation. Select, let's say this time we want to select something from emphasis. So we are selecting style emphasis. Click on that. It will show you in the as a preview in the slide. Click on OK and you can see that the animation has been applied. First slide we have done. Let's select the second slide where we have an image. Click on the image and as soon as you click and select it, take your pointer to the add option and from the themes, choose a theme that you like. You can click on the theme to see the preview on the slide. So this is how it will look like. If you are happy with this, you can just click on OK and you will see that this animation has been applied. We go to the next slide where again there is a picture and we select this picture because we have to apply the animation to this picture. Left click on it to select it. Then bring your pointer to the add option. Click on that and from the custom animations available, select the one which you like. For instance, we're looking at many of them here. So we are selecting expand and you can see how it expands in the preview of the slide. Click on OK and in the preview window, you will see that the custom animation has been applied. We select the fourth slide where we have this computer image. So we have to apply the custom animation to the image. So select the image by left clicking on it. Click on add. Left click on add. And then from the custom animation options available, let's select one which we like. We're selecting the wheel option and you can see the slide appears, the image appears like a wheel. Click on OK and this custom animation has been applied to the image. Next, take your pointer to the text, click on that so that the text gets selected. The box appears also around the text. Take the pointer to the add option in custom animation. Left click on that and again from this time we are selecting from emphasis. Scroll down to see more options and we are selecting the reveal underline or lighten. So one of these animations we select and click on OK and we can see that that animation has got applied. So this way you can apply the custom animation to all your text or images to make your presentation more presentable. Now save the file with your name and the title Impress Test on the desktop and show it to your teacher. Let us now see the correct way. So to save the file, we can see that in the title bar, we see that it's already saved as class 12. So we need to now do a save as. So to change the file name. So we can click, take a pointer to the file option. Left click on that, as is being shown here. And click on the save as option. You see a box which opens up. You have to select the location where you want to save your file. So since we are supposed to save it on desktop, we select desktop and then in the file name we can select and use backspace to clear any file name which is already written. You have to write CS or computer shiksha, your name and then test. So in this case we are writing CS Impress and test, but you have to save it on the desktop with your name. So write CS your name and test and then click on save. So you can see in the title bar here this file has been saved as CS Impress test. So this is how you're supposed to save your file. We request all teachers, trainers to check if all the students have completed the test. In the next class, all of you will appear for a written test with multiple choice answers. From the four options for each question, there is only one right answer and you need to tick on that.